Hello friends, welcome back once again. In the last video, we have learned how to set up your Microsoft Teams account, how we can change your profile picture, how you can show your status availability, whether you are available, busy, do not disturb, and so on. How you can set up your status message and how you can customize your status message. Then how you can use this save tab, then what are the settings which are necessary or beneficial for you and how you can set those settings, then which are the keyboard shortcuts. Then we have studied about the application or about the Microsoft Teams software. Then here two options were there: download the desktop app and download the mobile app. Here, if you see closely, here I am not finding download the desktop tab, as I have run or I have opened the Microsoft Teams desktop applications. Therefore, it is asking or this option is changed by check for updates. And as usual, if I want to download the mobile applications, I can click on this or how we can download the mobile application that already we have studied in the last video. And finally, how you can sign out of your Microsoft Teams account. Now, let us move ahead and let us learn the functions and the few more things regarding this left-hand side of this Microsoft Teams application or software. These are activity, chat, teams, assignments, calendars, calls, files, and so on. Out of that, in this video, we are going to focus on this activity tab and chat tab. Let us start with the activity tab. Here, inside that activity tab, I am going to get two options. Those are feed and my activity. Right now, as we have just started using this application, so we haven't done or we haven't initiated any of the chat or any of the conversation. We haven't participated in any of the Google Teams or challenges. As a result of that, inside this feed as well as my activity, it will be shown nothing. But as and when I am going to make use of all the functionalities of this software, so definitely I will get some feeds as well as my activity. Meanwhile, you can assume or you can say that this activity tab is similar to our notification tab in our mobile phone. Suppose if I miss any of the phone call, then what will happen? On the home screen of mobile phone, I will get that notification. This activity tab is similar to that only. Who has sent a message to you, who has scheduled the meeting, who has sent the meeting credentials to you, then what you have done, which replies you have given, which messages you have sent, that all those things will be shown here inside this feed as well as my activity. Now let us go ahead and deep dive into this chat section. Suppose I have to initiate the private chat with any of the colleagues or student inside my organization. Then with the help of this functionality or with the help of this button, I can initiate that chatting or conversation. Here, in order to start that conversation or chatting, two options are there. By clicking here on new chat, I can start that chatting, or you can go upsides and here like pen and paper one symbol is there. By clicking on this as well, you can initiate that chatting. I will click here, then I will get here with whom you want to have that chatting. Suppose I will type his name, and suppose I have selected a colleague with whom I need to or I want to start my chatting or conversation. After typing his name like this, I will get, and by moving the cursor on his name like this window, short window, I will get. It will show his name, whether he is available for chatting or as it is here shown as offline. Here, in the last video, we have learned how to set the status or how we can make yourself available, busy, do not disturb, be right back and appear away. But here, instead of all these five options, I am finding one new option that is nothing but the offline. It means he is not signed into his Microsoft Teams account. That's why it is shown as offline. Or he might have signed out from his account. Now suppose I want to send him an email. Here I will get his email address. I can select this email address. I can paste it into Outlook, or by simply clicking on this, I can send an email to this person. Now here, as his name is Ashutosh Pate, I am finding here AK, his initials I am finding. It means this Ashutosh Pate haven't updated his profile picture yet. As a result of that, I am finding his initials here. Now just go below his account. What I can find a chat symbol. By clicking on this, I can start chatting with him. Then beside that one email symbol is there. By clicking on this, I can send an email directly to Ashutosh Kate. If I want to know his organizational details or hierarchy in which he or the position in which he is working, if I want to know, I can click here and I will get to know. Then two more buttons are there. This video call means if I want to have the chatting, or if I want to have the conversation with him by making the video call, by clicking on this button, I can make a video call to him. Or if I want to make the audio call, by clicking on this button, I can make the audio call. If I want to send the message to Ashutosh Kate, not necessary to go towards this bottommost portion. What I can do, I can simply move cursor over his name and I can find like this window. I can go here, I can type what message I want to send and I can click on this. Easily that message I can send. Let us explore how we can send the messages. Let us say I want to say him or I want to greet him with good morning. Now how we can customize it. In order to customize it, I have to click on this collapse compose box. Here different options similar to our Microsoft Word I will get. I can make it as a, make this message as a bold. I can make it as a italic, underline, strike through. If I want to highlight it with the help of some color, I can select it and I can highlight it. Suppose I want to change the font color, I can change that color. Similarly, if I want that message to be large size, medium sized, or small size, that I can select by using this option. Then if I want this message to be a paragraph, heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, that I can select from here. And if you want no any formatting, what I can do, I can click here. It will clear all the formatting and as usual default message we can send. Then if I want that message to be at the left hand side, exactly at the center or towards right hand side, suppose I want to add bullets to that message or bullets in that message, I can click here, I can add the bullets. If I want to add the numberings, I can click here and I can add it. If I want to use the quotations, I can use. And let us say along with this message I want to send some link with it. Let us say that I want to say good morning, and along with that message suppose I want to add some link. Let us say, and I will click, sorry I have missed here, but if I will click on insert, see what I have got here. I have got that message with purple color and here link I have got. Means as soon as the receiver Ashutosh will click on this message or this good morning, he will be diverted towards this Google. Now here only one option, collapse compose box, we have explored. Like that number of options are there. Let us move ahead or dive into each and every option one by one. Second is setup delivery options, means what I need to say inside that message, whether it is important, whether it is urgent, with the time and date at which we have to submit this application or the project which is undergoing, that we can set out with the help of this set delivery options. Beside that, one more option is there. Suppose I want to attach a file. Here it will ask whether to upload a file from OneDrive or upload from the computer. Let us say I will upload that file from the computer. That file will be shown here. And like that, number of files you can upload, and you can just click. You have to just after uploading your file, you have to just click on this send button, and that file will be sent to him. Then after that, if you want to add some emojis in order to have the healthy conversation, you can add among these. Then if you want to add the GIFs, you can add out of these any. Then if you want to add some special stickers, you can select out of these many stickers and you can add any one of them. Then after that, schedule meeting is there, stream is there, and phrase is there. These three we will cover in subsequent video series. Then here three dots are there. Here few more third party applications are there with the help of which, suppose you want to send something, easily you can send. Suppose I want to add something from the YouTube. I can click on the YouTube, and here I can click on the add or open. And here, let us say I want to send one video link. Yes, Microsoft Teams tutorial. Suppose this file I want to send, just I will click there, and like this I will get here. And after that, I can click on the send button, and that message will be sent to Ashutosh Kate. Now let us say that in this message which you have sent, you want to add, or if you want to add something, or if you want to edit it, what you need to do, you need to move the cursor on the message you have sent. Like this, you will get few emojis, and beside those emojis you will get the three dots. You can click on those three dots and you can click on the edit option, and easily you can edit what you want to edit. And after that, you can click on this done button, and that message will be once again edited. Now suppose if you want to delete this message, once again over this message you have to move the cursor, you will get like this. You can click on these three dots and you can click on the delete message. Now here it will be shown this message has been deleted. If you want to undo it, you can undo it. Similarly, suppose you want to save that message. As in the first video we have seen what is the function of this saved button. Now let us make use of it. Suppose I want to save this message, or this is a very important message that I need to look into it after some time. Then what I need to do, just I need to move the cursor on that message and I need to click on these three dots, and what I need to do, I need to save this message. Then what I will get, I will get that pop-up window as that message is saved, and here inside saved button will get this message. Okay, now if I will move cursor over that message, what I will get, number of options are there. Suppose I want to unsave that message, that is also there. If I want to edit, that already we have discussed. If I want to delete, that already we have discussed. Like that, number of options are there. Those you will explore when you will start using this Microsoft Teams software excessively. Now suppose I want to make an audio call. You have to pay your attention towards the uppermost right corner. I want to have the conversation, or I have initiated the chatting with Ashutosh Kate, but I want to make audio call. Here one more option is there. Means in order to make the audio call and video call to Ashutosh Kate, two options are there. बाई यूजिंग दीज टू बटन्स आई कैन मेक ऑडियो कॉल एंड वीडियो कॉल, और आई कैन मूव द कर्सर ऑन हिज नेम एंड फ्रॉम हियर एज वेल. हियर ऑल्सो टू ऑप्शंस आर देयर विद द हेल्प ऑफ विच इजिली आई कैन मेक ऑडियो कॉल और वीडियो कॉल टू आशुतोष काटे. एंड हियर बिसाइड दिस वीडियो कॉल एंड ऑडियो कॉल वन मोर टैब इज देयर दैट इज स्क्रीन शेयरिंग. सपोज आई वॉन्ट टू शेयर माई स्क्रीन विथ आशुतोष काटे, देन आई कैन क्लिक हियर एंड हियर आई विल गेट द डिफरेंट ऑप्शन. एनी स्पेसिफिक विंडो यू वॉन्ट टू शेयर विथ आशुतोष काटे और यू वॉन्ट टू शेयर ऑल द डेस्कटॉप विथ आशुतोष काटे. नाउ एज ही इज ऑफ लाइन आई विल नॉट बी एबल टू डू इट, सो आई विल क्लोज इट. नाउ बिसाइड द शेयर द स्क्रीन हियर टू मोर ऑप्शन आर देयर. लेट अस एक्सप्लोर द फर्स्ट ऑप्शन हियर एड पीपल. मीन्स सपोज इन दिस चैट इफ आई विल आई वॉन्ट टू एड फ्यू मोर नेम्स दैट इजिली आई कैन एड. I can search for the name and just click on the add. That person will be added to this group chat. Here I can find this group chat we have created, that is Ashutosh and Tushar. Here once again I can write the message and once again same options are there. If I want to make it as a bold, italic, underline, strike through, like this, all the options already we have discussed and same options are available in Microsoft Office as well. Similarly, if I want to insert a link, I can insert a link. If I want to insert the horizontal line, I can insert the horizontal line. Then if I want to insert the table, I can select number of rows, number of columns, I can insert the table. If I want to write inside the table, I can write inside the table. I can set the delivery options, whether it is standard, important, urgent, with a deadline, with a date and specific time. Then if I want to attach a file, it will ask whether to upload or attach that file from OneDrive or from your computer. Then I can add emojis, GIFs and stickers if I wish to. And these three options, that is schedule a meeting, then stream and phrase, that we are going to discuss in latter part of this video series. And if I want to add some YouTube link, then also we can use that YouTube link like that. You can search and you can add like this YouTube link if I wish so, and I can click on the send button. And that message will be delivered to Ashutosh and Kate. This is a group chat. Here also same options are there. Suppose I want to edit the message which I have sent. Then what I can do? I can move the cursor on this message. And there like this window I will get. I just click on the three dots. Then I will get the different options. If I want to save this message, I can save this message. If I will save this message, what will happen? That message will be visible under your profile under saved messages. If I want to edit that message, a specific part, if you want to edit, you can edit and you can click on the done. That your edit will be updated. Then if you want to delete the message, you can delete the message. Similarly, number of options are there. Those we will explore later on. Suppose I want to delete the message, I can delete the message and the message will be shown. This message has been deleted. Now, suppose I want to make an audio call to this group, matlab Ashutosh and Tushar. Then by clicking here, I can make the audio call as well as I can make the video call. Similarly, during video call, if I want to share the screen with Ashutosh and Tushar, easily I can share this screen by clicking on this button. Now beside that button, once again, if I want to add a few more members inside this group chat, I can click on the add people and I can add the number of persons which I wish to add inside this group chat. Suppose I want to leave this group chat, there one more option is there. You can click here and you can leave this group chat. And if you leave this group chat, you will not be able to post the messages inside this group chat. Similarly, one more button is there, that is pop out chat. If I will click on this, what will happen? This chatting window will be minimized. Previously it was at full screen, it will be minimized, and rest of the things inside this Microsoft Teams applications easily you can perform. Now I hope that everybody has understood. Before that, here you can come here which group chat we have created, and beside that few buttons are there. Chat is there means here all the conversations will be there on this window, and beside that files are there means if I have shared the files through that group chat or private chat, there I can find the files at this location. And if I want to share the location, share the files at in this group chat, I can click here. It will ask whether to share or share those files from OneDrive or upload from the computer. And depending upon where the file location is, you can choose either of the option and you can share the files. Suppose like that, number of tabs you want to add. Easily you can add. If you want an Excel file, you can add OneNote, PDF file. Like that, number of applications are there with the help of which we can add the different types of files at this location or different types of tabs beside these tabs. This is regarding group chat. Similar is the case with the private chat. Here, I can inside the chat tab, I will find the chats inside the file types. I can find the shared files in this chat. If no files are there, or if I want to share the files, I can click on the files and I will come to share. It will ask whether to choose file from OneDrive or upload from computer. Depending upon file location, we will select any of these two options and we can easily share the file. Similarly, if I want to add any of the tab here, I can click here, and out of these many number of options, I can select it and I can add that tab here. Now I hope that everybody has understood how we can use the activity button, then how we can use the chat button in order to have the private chats and group chats effectively. Then see you then in the next video. We will discover how we can make use of Teams tab and how we can create and manage different teams and channels. Then see you at the next video from this video series. Thank you so much.